Previously, we had a very big interest in the Western tourists. But today we found the reality. The Malay tourist has four principles that they are very much comfortable with us. Number one, they are conserving. Number two, they are preserving. Number three, they are creating financial feedback. And the last one, they are enlightening us. I will discuss to you about that four things next moment, not today. Inshallah, you will understand why we emphasize more on the Malay tourists. We never kick out any other tourists. Like a few days ago, like I just mentioned to you yesterday, when Jihan gave me a call, Bang Fatlan, there's people from French. And the biodiversity merit professors coming to Aceh, they stay 1 week in Sabang, and then they come back again, and they need a tourist guide. I was a tourist guide at the time. So we spent amazing days, only one day, only a couple of hours. But I hope we will have a good impact at the end to promote the biodiversity of Wei Island to the Western world, especially European countries. All right, so we never kick out any other person, but we prefer to have the people who compliances to the four elements. Okay, conserving, preserving, creating financial feedback, and enlightening. If you don't understand that yet, I will discuss to you later. Maybe we can discuss in MPA. You know MPA? Majelis Parusata Aceh. We just formed it a couple of weeks ago at the end of Ramadan. 27 days of Ramadan. We finally created that. And then we did the soft launching. And in MPA, we discussed about tourism, about making concepts, about making consultation, especially also in upgrading your English if you want. And we will discuss about the tourism concepts and tourism contents. The thing that I learned in America before, I brought it here for us to discuss. It doesn't say that I'm smart, no. It's not about smartness, it's about sharing. Karena kadang-kadang kita lebih dahulu tahu, kita bagi tahu seorang seolah kita pintar, bukan. Cuma kita kedua-dua tahu. Kalau sudah sama-sama tahu, tidak ada yang lebih pintar. Everybody is the same. Right? Okay, so yesterday, we discussed also with Jihan that we need to do some simulation. Yeah, I want to know, I think some of you already passed, yeah? Some, I still have a curiosity to know about your ability and your inside of ability or your personality and your self-confidence. Some of you, especially the ladies. But I will do it later, okay? We'll do some simulation later. I have one question for you guys. So, from the whole of you, all of you, how many percent of you spend your time in tourism? I mean, you regard your main source of income from tourism. How many of you? Can you raise your hand? You get my point? Dari semua ini, ada berapa orang kira-kira yang kira-kira income-nya itu sebagian besar dari tourism? Yang kita mengandalkan dari tourism? 1, 2. Okay. Only 2, 3, 4 including me. Anybody else? Okay, don't worry. One day, you will make it as your base for your life. When you get yourself very well equipped with the knowledge, very well equipped with the insights, and very well equipped with your English capability, you will get money from that. Because being a tourist guide is something very different. I was a person in TIC, yeah? Sorry, ITC, Information Tourism Center, like what we did in Ulele, like then I delegated to Jihan. That job was very amazing because we meet all the new person all the day. Yeah, we discuss with the new person and then we got some, you know, some respect from them. This is very important to shape you. I think we only have few years to enjoy that. I finished that and Jihan now replacing me. I think Jihan will stop because that only one step in our life and we'll go another step closer up. So at the end, I believe you, when you start from nothing, I mean, your insight, your knowledge, your capability, your self-confidence. But now you are a person now, you're getting better, better and better, inshallah. In other few months or few years, you will be a professional trainer. Don't worry, because Aceh now, in the eye of the tourist, unless we never promote it, you have to promote it and saying that you are able to speak in their languages. French, English, Spanish, Arabic, okay, German,
Esperanto.
Everybody is here. And also some Mandarin here, I believe so. Okay? Alright. So now we will go to another. We make a circle to go to Souvenir Shop. Aceh Souvenir Shop, yeah? Aceh, yeah? Aceh, Aceh Gallery. And then at that place, we will try to understand how, in the quote, how to persuade, mempengaruhi, bagaimana mempengaruhi the tourists to buy things. One way to do so is by explaining the financial feedback to them, explaining the effect of creating financial feedback to them, they will buy the things. You get my point. Jadi dalam empat syarat tadi yang saya katakan, wisatawan ideal itu memenuhi konsep konservasi, preservasi, menciptakan feedback secara ekonomi, dan memberikan pencerahan. Nomor tiga itu kita uraikan sebelum mereka turun ke lokasi sebenarnya. Jadi kita katakan, semenjak kita start tourism kita pada tahun 2010, okay, sampai sekarang, dahulu 2010, toko souvenir kita bisa hitung dengan jari, adik-adik. Sedikit sekali. Yang bertahan itu yang sudah dari dulu-dulu seperti apa Waila ya, lain-lain itu sedikit sekali. Ini semua baru bertumbuh dalam 10 tahun. Tidak sampai 10 tahun, mungkin dalam 7-8 tahun. Jadi kita start itu 2010. 2011 Banda Aceh membuat apa? Visit Banda Aceh Year, masih ingat 2011 dengan Pak Reza. Pak Reza waktu itu baru jadi Kadis Kota. Kita berani meluncurkan itu dan beliau punya konsep untuk membuat 10 pusat informasi pariwisata. 10 plannya demikian rupa. Tapi kita dari swasta sudah membuat satu dan sekarang sudah kita serahkan kepada dinas. Waktu itu kita dari Yayasan Ekowisata Aceh. 2010 Juli kita sudah membuat ITC dan itu sudah berjalan dengan sekarang. Kemudian beritahu kepada wisatawan bahwasanya efek yang mereka ciptakan dalam sisi ekonomi itu sangat besar. Dan yang terpenting adalah you have to tell them all the money goes to the locals. Uang itu semua kembali kepada orang lokal. Maka di sini bermain dengan pengalaman, adik-adik. Jadi pada saat kalian mungkin duduk melihat tamu berbelanja, kalian akan melihat begitu banyak orang masuk ke kedai pusaka, contohnya membawa box, membawa kotak-kotak, itu seperti sendal, seperti benda-benda karya dari Aceh Besar, seperti dari kawasan Bait Aceh Sibirek sana, seperti rencong, itu dibawa oleh masyarakat. Jadi pemiliknya adalah masyarakat. Pusaka sebagai kedai souvenir adalah media, ya, media yang menyalurkan itu kepada pembeli. Jadi uangnya kembali kepada masyarakat. So the money goes to the locals. Jadi mereka berpikir uang ini kalau kita belanjakan akan berkah kepada masyarakat. Jadi ini yang kalian ulang-ulang dalam bus kalau mereka turun. Mereka paham betul uang itu nggak lari kemana-mana. Karena sejujurnya orang Malaysia khususnya atau Melayu begitu melihat Aceh, mereka tercengang karena ekonomi kita ramai kita yang pegang. Mereka berpikir kedai-kedai di sini tuh orang Cina punya seperti negara mereka. Tapi no, kita di sini masih orang Aceh yang berjualan. Jadi dengan mereka tahu uang itu lari kepada masyarakat, maka mereka akan lebih bersemangat berbelanja. Jadi kita bicara mengenai efek ekonomi kepada mereka, kepada masyarakat, menstimulasi mereka untuk lebih banyak berbelanja. That's the most important way for you to explain that. And they will buy a lot as much as they can. Okay. Kemudian juga jelaskan kepada para tamu bahwasanya Aceh sudah pandai mengemas produk-produk kecil. Jadi kita tidak mesti beli yang besar seperti rencong dalam bingkai, nggak mesti, ya kan? Benda-benda kecil seperti apa fridge magnet, seperti keychain, ya kan? Yang murah-murah yang 5 ribuan itu kita sudah produksi banyak. Sudah massive produk. Jadi mereka akan bisa membeli dengan mudah dengan jumlah besar. Dan kadang-kadang kalau duitnya nggak cukup, juga dia bisa beli dalam jumlah sedikit saja. Tapi mereka poinnya membeli. Itu saja. satu hari dulu dengan dengan kondisi seperti ini ya, adik-adik, kamunya anggaplah kita mengisi semua turun berbelanja, begitu kembali ke dalam bus seperti ini, mereka nggak punya tempat duduk lagi. Sudah penuh dengan box mereka, di bawah penuh, di dalam juga penuh. Ini poinnya apa? Ternyata mereka membelinya dalam jumlah yang sangat besar. Jadi akibatnya ekonomi kita bergerak. Maka bermunculanlah kedai-kedai seperti ini. That's one strategy for you to apply in your life as a throwback. Karena uang itu akan kembali kepada kita, akan kembali kepada masyarakat. Alright, we are here.
Yes, alright.
Aceh Gallery, we will go step by step down and then we'll be in a big group, okay? Don't go anywhere, only unless you are in a big group.
Hi ladies.
Oh, choice.